Susanna Martin was a witch who dwelled in Amesbury. With a brilliant eye and saucy tongue, she worked her sorcery. And when unto the judge's court the sheriffs brought her hither, the lilacs drooped as she passed by, and then were seen to wither. A witch she was, though trim and neat, comely head held high. It did not seem that one as she was Satan so would vie. And when in court the afflicted ones proclaimed her evil ways, she laughed aloud and boldly met Cotton Mather's gaze. Who hath bewitched these maids? He asked, and strong was her reply. If they be dealing in blackguards, you know as well as I. And then the afflicted ones made moan as she approached near. They saw her shape upon the beam, so none could doubt was there. The neighbors round swore to the truth of her satanic powers, that she could fly o'er land and stream and come dry shod through showers. At night was said she had appeared, her cat fearsome mean. Avoid the she-devil, they had cried, to keep their spirits clean. The spectral evidence was weighed, and stern the parson spoke, "Thou shalt not suffer a witch to live, 'tis written in the book." Susanna Martin, so accused, spake with flaming eyes, "I scorn these things, for they are not but filthy gossip's lies." Now those bewitched, they cried her out aloud, their voices rang. They saw a bird above her head, an evil yellow thing. And so beneath the summer sky, Susanna Martin died. And still in scorn she faced the rope, her comely head held high. Susanna Martin was a woman, lived in Amesbury.